Hey there. Something really strange has been happening since I got home from the last case. People are dying, and there's no rational explanation why. Whatever's going on here is way beyond my understanding. Can you help? Come to Twola, and I'll tell you what I found so far. Hi, I'm so glad you came. In the last month, a lot of people have mysteriously died here in Twola. The only common factor I could find was that all of the victims were in front of their TVs at the time of death. We can talk more inside. Please, help me. What's happening? No! No! The police investigation hasn't uncovered any leads. The causes of death are still undetermined. My good friend, Professor Landon, was one of the deceased. I conducted my own investigation and discovered that each victim was found in front of the TV. It's strange. The TVs were given to the victims by the Tuola Television Company for free. The police found four corpses in our small town of Tuola over the last few weeks.
All dispatchers are currently busy. If this is an emergency, please contact your local police station directly.
Twola Police Department, Officer Stevenson speaking.
What? Another one? For your safety, please, come to the police station immediately. I'm currently the only one at the station, so I can't leave. Everyone else is out investigating similar cases. If I give you the address, can you write it down? Police Station, 13 Red Street.
Start at Samoro Fish Sushi Bar. Turn right to reach Tiffany's Jewelry. Go past the music school until you reach the movie theater. Follow the road past the Elven Shop Toy Store. Turn right twice to reach the Sky Map Observatory. Continue on past the Central Park. In 400 meters, you'll see the National Technical University. Cross the bridge near the History Museum and follow the road past the Rapunzel Hair Salon. Once you pass the bowling alley, turn left twice to reach the nightclub. Turn right at the Rosie Restaurant and follow the road to the Drunken Joe Pub. Stay on the road past the Sports Car Club, and you will arrive at the police station.
You hear they found another body on the other side of town? It happened at almost the same time with the same cause of death. Weird, right?
I guess. Maybe it was just a coincidence. David had a weak heart. He said it was bothering him when we were talking in the archive last week. Maybe it was just a heart attack. I can't believe he's gone. We worked together for so long.
Those eyes. Those terrible eyes. Thanks. I think we graduated to first name basis after you saved my life. I'm Kevin. Let me tell you a little more about the cases. The criminologists say that the first crime scene has the most evidence. You'll need to go to the archive to get more information about the first victim, Professor Landon. I'll give you the access code. None of my devices are working. I'll need to be in constant contact with the others while I'm on duty. If you need me, I'll be using the radio in my car. The station isn't safer than anywhere else right now. Let me know if you need to go somewhere. I'll be happy to take you. Thank you.
They found Professor Landon dead in his own laboratory. Nothing suspicious at the scene, just some crystals on his desk.
Think it was a suicide? People used to mock him. Some called him insane. Maybe he started to take it personal.
It looks like the most probable cause of death is electric shock, likely received during an unsuccessful experiment.
So, the newspapers were right. The old man really was out of his mind.
You know how Professor Landon claimed Madeline Foster and the Twala Television Company were trying to mind control everyone? Most of the Twala people don't share his opinion. We're grateful to Ms. Foster for everything she's done for us. Twala was practically a ghost town not so long ago. After the quarry stopped working, there were no jobs and folks started to leave. Once Ms. Foster established the Twala Television Company, the city really started to grow. People started working again. We even had folks come in from other cities. Everything was amazing. Now I'm starting to wonder if Landon might have been onto something.
You're on Professor Landon's property. If you're from the Twala Television Company, turn around now. You have 5 seconds before I call the police. If you're one of my students, then you're smart enough to find the house key and let yourself in.
Detective, I assume you're here to investigate this case. Good, I'd help you, but I'm so weak. You'll find what you need in my laboratory.
Thank you.
made an interesting and equally terrifying discovery. The Twola Television Company has begun installing crystals in their new TV sets. I'm not sure how the crystals work. They appear to connect the real world to the ghost dimension. Every person watching a Twola television is in danger. I must learn how far this conspiracy goes.
I will be the first to leave the dark realm of death and return to the land of the living. Soon, I'll gather enough energy to restore myself to flesh and blood. There is nothing you foolish people can do to stop me.
Staring at screens. Now the Twola Television Company is just giving away TVs. Are they trying to melt everyone's mind completely? That's different.
Thank you.
Crystals I found in the TVs made by the Twola Television Company have some very unusual features. Kramer and I have conducted a number of experiments on them, but we still haven't determined what they do exactly. Kramer was hurt during one of the tests and refuses to continue. Ah, what a baby! It's a good thing I can finish these experiments on my own. I need to get to the bottom of this.
huge giveaway from the Tuwalla Television Company. The Tuwalla Television Company is celebrating its 10th anniversary and wants to thank all city residents for the company's success by giving a new Super TV set to every household absolutely free. Professor Landon and Mr. Kramer expose the conspiracy. Professor Landon and his friend, the widely known geologist, Andrew Kramer, came forward with hard-hitting allegations against the Tuwalla Television Company. The scientists claim that the new Super TV hypnotizes people and that the Tuwalla Television Company is using the people of Tuwalla as their test subjects in mind control experiments. Madeline Foster speaks out on mind control allegations. Madeline Foster, the founder of Tuwalla Television Company, spoke out about the allegations made by Professor Landon and Mr. Kramer, saying, "There is no conspiracy. This is just the fever dreams of two crazy old men with too much time on their hands. We are the future. The Tuwalla Television Company is grateful to everyone who has stood with us and chosen to buy our products."
Hello. Oh, you'd like to talk to Mr. Kramer? Please wait here. I'll call him. And Meredith, Mr. Kramer's maid. How could I be so foolish? I never should have brought this TV here. I fell for the free TV promotion, and now look what happened. I'll leave it to you. I don't want to ruin your investigation more than I already have. Here, take this.
Huh? What's this? Goodness gracious, what is that thing? Why would Meredith bring that thing here? I've told her millions of times I don't want anything from the Twola TV company in my house. I practically barricaded myself in this house after Landon died. I obviously can't investigate the matter further when I'm here, but I'd be even less useful if I was dead. The only way to figure out what caused these deaths is to learn where the strange crystals came from. Here, use this on the door.
geologists discovered strange crystal deposits while investigating seismic activity in a quarry near Twola. Before they could properly inspect the quarry, a local television company bought out the deposit and suspended the research.
I need to tell you something, Detective. I've been hearing someone's voice in my head ever since that incident at the station. It tells me really twisted things. It's horrifying. Hopefully, I won't completely lose it before this is over.
Don't try to stop me, puny human!
Thank you. batch of crystal our master needs. Let's go.
Over 600 years ago, the sorcerer Razos summoned the horrendous demon Caspian. His appearance filled people's hearts with terror. He had hundreds of sharp fangs and dozens of dreadful tentacles. Caspian drained Razos' soul and separated his flesh from the bones. Not satisfied with one innocent soul, Caspian went to the nearby village of Lighthill. He had no mercy for the men that fought against him with pitchforks and hammers. Evil can't remain unnoticed for long. A secret order of monks had been tracking monsters like demons, zombies, and walking skeletons. Tahirar, the order's head, noticed Caspian and knew that such a mighty demon couldn't be killed easily. Tahirar used a powerful spell to kill the demon and enclosed his soul in a crystal. He knew that neither swords nor axes could harm Caspian. Tahirar gathered all his power and defeated the demon with a massive spell. Caspian was enclosed in a crystal forever, but it cost Tahirar his life.
Please return me to my body. I'll do anything you want. I can show you how to get to the TV factory if that's what you're after.
thanks for saving me. I'm Owen, the mining crew supervisor. The Twola TV company ordered us to mine these crystals. It turns out, they're all just fragments of one huge crystal. I never would have said yes if I knew what they needed the crystals for. Take the train car to the factory and use this key. There's a room that no one is allowed to go to. They must be hiding something in there.
Thank you.